Hello, in this tutorial you will learn how to model the celebrated Arne Jacobsen egg chair using clay. Then we are going to start by placing some pictures, some drawings we have downloaded from the internet on our scene just to be used as a reference. We will lock them and we will start by creating a sphere, clay sphere, polygonal. Yes, let's move a bit to have it centered on our picture. And we will start changing the radius to make it be more or less adapted to the chair shape. Something like this will work, and we just accept to add the sphere to our scene. So from here we will continue adapting it. And now we will just delete some of the faces. To start adapting to the chair shape, maybe these two as well, and I will also delete a half of my object to later work with the symmetry. Then now from this point, let's say I want to delete also these faces, and I will start by selecting faces and points and edges, trying to move them or scale them or even delete some of them like this one to adapt my shape to the picture I have behind. And then once we are happy with the result, we just go and select all of the points that are supposed to be on the same plane to create the symmetry. So those in here, and just we'll make all of them to be on the same plane using the project to plane tool here. And instead of selecting any of the given planes, I will create a new one using the set plane by line option. And with the help of the smart track, I will place all of the points on the same plane. So now I can easily create the symmetry of the entire object. Clay symmetry, and we'll use the edge loop selecting these edges. Now once we have selected the symmetry done, we can again try to readjust the shape to a shape to the picture. Okay, let's say that now we are happy with the result, so we just select the entire object and add a thickness. Maybe 3.5 will be okay. Or just a little bit more, a bit thicker like this. Click OK. This message just tell us that the symmetry has broken because of the symmetry, and I have seen this on this edges. I'm going to modify a little bit and this too as well.
And now we will move everything on this thing, so we'll unlock the drawings and just move this vertex to the origin, and from here we will start creating. We will move everything a bit upper. It's going out. Placing maybe here, and we'll lock again the drawings, and we'll start creating the leg using a cylinder. Let's do it something like this. And select cut mode. In this case, I will select polygonal in both top and bottom. And okay, let's move it a bit upper. And now we will just go to the polygonal mode. I'm going to hide my chair. Now let's select this and these edges and create a split division from first this edges on the top, and now let's do the same for the edges at the bottom. Yes. Just these edges and create the split division here. So we have sharper edges here now for the cylinder. And let's start creating the legs, the arms for the legs here. We will create, let's say, a box. I'm gonna change the number of divisions, the thickness here. Well, set one division in each axis. We'll leave something like this. I'm going to add one division somewhere like here. And we'll move these faces down. This now we'll move it. This one bit. I'm going just to extract these three faces. Copy them. Just move the edges. And let's work on this arm again. Adding some divisions, so let's try creating an inset. An individual is just to meet with more distance. Let's see the result. Yeah, this could work, but I think I rather prefer to add some divisions and some points on the arm. Let's hide the cylinder and also this leader support here. Let's add some divisions on this arm. And here, let's add let's do this with split sides. One more division. And here. Let's see, we will need to add some sides on these edges as well. And yes, now we have sharper edges. And we like it much more, the result. Let's show the whole shell. And let's work on this to hide everything but this support here. We'll work on it by adding thickness. So we will create a shell on it. Let's do something like this. Okay, and now we'll add some divisions to have sharper edges on it. Okay, we'll add one here. here. And then I will create some inset for these faces. Inset individual, let's see. No, I don't like a lot. Look too much of the result, so let's try with subdivisions. One in here, one in here. Let's see a new result. Yeah, this is much more what we were looking for. And we can also add some division. In here, yes, let's show the rest of the object. Yes, this is better adapted to what we were looking for. Let's select the object and place it over here. Now let's work on this to only, so invert the selection and hide. And now I think I won't need again my drawings, so I will unlock them and just change the new layer. That I will turn off. Now I want to create a symmetry with this object, but I want before do this to cut my leg, this leg, to create the symmetry and have four objects not intersecting themselves. So I will create a line with 45 degrees. I will mirror it here. And now we will split this object with these two lines, so we will use the knife tool here and select the start and the end of the lines I want to use as a knife. So this one and this one. And now I will just select all of these faces here. Delete them. Sorry, I wanted to do these lines longer. Let's undo the process to the point we didn't use the knife here and now. Let's do these lines longer. And now, yes, we will use them as a knife. and this one. And we will select all of these faces here. Just to have this object and create a symmetry from it. We'll select these two objects and go to symmetry. We will create the symmetry for one of them. We'll use a plane. Like this. And we'll do the same for the support here. Using the y-axis, and now I will rotate the objects, creating a copy, yes, from 0 to 90 degrees, and that's great. Let's see the results subdivided. We can leave like this for now, and we'll turn on the rest of the objects. Now we can see the whole shell. We will just separate our different parts in different layers, so we'll create one for the shell. And one for the left, one for the legs arm, and one more for the supports. Yes. So now I will work again over the chair just to create a seat area, a flatter area here to allow us to sit on the chair. So I will select all of these faces, all of the central faces as well, and now we will just eliminate them. Now let's select the edges, all of the points there. I will try to use the collapse points here to create a flatter surface there to sit on the chair. We can now create from these faces also maybe we will need an inset but my bisector for example. Now let's move these faces a bit down. And now let's try to have all of these points projected on the same plane. So I will just go to project plane and I will select the XY plane and then we'll move all of the new points Like this will work, just to make sure that all of them are on the same plane and the surface is flatter. Okay, and now I will create a cushion for our chair from these faces too, that I will extract from our object, extract and copy, yes, then we have this new surface that I will scale, and from which we will create a shell to give a thickness. Allowing us to create a cushion for our chair. Okay, we'll do it a bit bigger now. We can move it now. And yes, this way we have the cushion created. Just let me make a bit bigger again. Yeah, something like this. And okay. And now yes, we can turn on again the legs. Maybe we could try to make the legs arms longer, so we will just select these faces and paste them, turn on the multi combos and just try to move all of them. Just let's select all of the faces but not the supports. We will move the supports later because they are in other, they have other orientation. So let's select these faces and let's move them with the multi combo active in the polygonal mode. That will work better. Yes, something like this. I will turn on the leg support and we'll select all of the objects here. Now I will try just to move them. They have different orientations, so let me move just one of them. And this is because they have symmetry. I will just delete this. I'm moving just this one over here. I will create a polar array. To have again all of the supports here, and that's how we have our actual modeler. So let's see it. The whole entire object on the subdivision mode. Finally, we could also, using the same techniques we have used for the chair, to model the footrest, like this one I am importing in the scene. Like this one, let me just change its layer. Footrest. And let's only put these curves here. Select I'll select the elements and copy and paste. And move the rest into Vulture. Finally, let's get out the edition mode in Clayu. And let's apply some material to our scene. Let's apply certain alignment to our leg and the leg arms. Some black plastic like this one to the support. Let's support here. And this yellow part for our chair and footrest. And okay. Then let's just move the XY plane. Now we will turn on a scene we had previously set here. Let me just select all of our chair and footrest components and move a bit on the scene to have them place it in a proper place. Let's do the middle a bit smaller. Something like this, maybe. Once we're ready, we just can go ahead and do a render using ray trace. To see a realistic result, we have already the material supplied and the scene prepared, so we just go to ray trace and let's start to see the result rendered.
If you could just see my face, then y'all would see I'm smiling.